Hi everybody, I'm Yashika from Besant Technologies. Today I'm here to talk to you about the different AWS certifications and about cloud computing. So all of you have come here to learn about AWS. Why do we actually need these certifications? There is something called APN, that is AWS Partner Network. Amazon requires these to maintain certain level of partner status with them. There are four steps in this process of APN. That would be like a register, a standard partner, advanced and premier. So in order to be a standard partner, you need to have two associate level certifications. In order to be an advanced partner, you need to have four associate level and two professional level certs. In order to be a premier partner, you need to have 20 associate level and 8 professional level certs. So now you understand the importance of these certifications. Now that we know what is the value of these certifications, let's see what are the different kinds of certifications available in AWS. The first one would be the AWS Certified Foundational Cloud Practitioner Exam. This is the basic level. Next comes the associate level, wherein we have three exams. The solutions architect, the developer, this is for developer roles, and SysOps admin would be for Windows admin and Linux admin. Next comes the developer level, wherein we have the solutions architect exam and the DevOps engineer exam. Then comes the specialty level, that is the topmost and toughest level, wherein we have three exams, advanced networking, big data and security. So before October 2018, what was the case is that if you had to sit in a developer level exam, you must have completed the associate level exam, that is the lower level exam. For example, if you had to sit in the solutions architect developer level exam, you should have passed the solutions architect associate level exam. But after October 2018, this is not the case required by AWS. Anybody can sit in any exam you wish. But the basic understanding is if you go through the exams in the proper order, you will have a better understanding of AWS. So now that we know about this, why should we go for Amazon? In 2019, the global public market share is predicted to increase by 17%, and AWS Amazon leads the market competing with Microsoft and Google. So we see from these certifications and the exam level and the Amazon's public cloud market share, we see the importance of these AWS certification, and it's also a very highly paying job. So now before we move on to cloud computing, let me tell you about the basic exam blueprint. The exam will be of 130 questions and it will be multiple choice question. Everything will be scenario based and the exam fees would be around $150. So now let me talk to you about cloud computing. So what is cloud computing? Instead of using the servers in your local computer, we go in for the servers to manage, process our data in the internet. That is why that is called cloud computing. What are the main advantages of cloud computing and that too in AWS? First would be trade capital expense for variable expense. Meaning, initially when we set up a business, we will have a lot of business setting up cost. So what happens is that when we additionally buy data servers, set up data centers, our cost is going to go up very much. So instead of doing that, we could directly go in with AWS cloud computing. The expense of this would be reduced, wherein you will pay only for what you use in the cloud. Then benefit from massive economies of scale, meaning when we want to purchase a new computing capacity or data server, what happens is that it becomes costlier when we do it from our side. But when we go to cloud, what happens, since they have hundreds and thousands of customers, they can lend the same capacity at a much cheaper rate. So this is one of the very big advantages of using the cloud in AWS, that is benefit from massive economies of scale. Next is stock guessing capacity. Suppose we start a new business, we do not know how much of computing capacity we need, how many data servers we need and all those things. So once we, there are two options, either we end up buying a lot of machinery and wasting these resources, or we have to work with a very limited capacity. now with AWS and cloud computing, both these issues will be solved. We need not guest capacity. Directly we can go to the cloud. As and when we need, we can purchase or increase or decrease our computing capacity. Then increase speed and agility. What this means is, suppose we need a new software or a new computing capacity available to our developers, it has to go through a lot of cycle in our department, IT cycle, approvals and lot. It takes a lot of time to get to the hands of your developer. So all the thing, this delays your business by a lot. This delays your business. So once we go with AWS, if you want to increase your computing capacity or purchase a new data server or new kind of servers, everything will be at just a quick step. So it will be at an increased speed. Your developers will get what they need in minutes. Then stop spending money running and maintaining data centers. So what happens when we have our own data center? We need to set up the data centers, maintain the servers, and what happens is that we need to have the security, data encryption, and all this comes with setting up data centers. Now what happens if we go to cloud and AWS is, we need not worry about any of this. We can just focus on the things what our business need. Rest of the part will be taken care by Amazon. Then global in minutes. Suppose we want to publish our business, we can do it immediately, right in a single step by just using AWS. So these are the advantages of cloud and AWS. To know more about these certifications and learn more, please visit